My name is Yumi, and I am originally from Japan. Have you ever been there?
Yeah.
Where did you go?
Tokyo.
Tokyo. Never heard of. My dad is a really old school Japanese man. He likes to be the man of the house, you know? And last time when I visited my parents, I brought a fancy Okanagan wine as a souvenir. And my mom was like, let's use our special wine glasses for a special wine. But then she dropped one of the glasses and there were broken glasses on the floor. And my dad came in and said, "Everyone, do not move. It's dangerous. Let me take care of it." And he took like 3 steps and went, "I think I stepped on the glass." "Yumi, can you get me rubbing alcohol?" And he lifted up his foot, and it was a tiny piece of rice cracker. Oh, I love my dad. His name is Eijiro, the man of the house, with the pain tolerance of Italian soccer player. Japan is a secretive country. I'm pretty sure you guys have some questions like, what's the deal with dolphin hunting? Or why there are vending machines of everything, including girls' used underwear? Oh, I know, it's weird. Who hunts dolphins? Well, let me answer those questions. Some people in Japan hunt dolphins for business and food source. They do it for their survival, and I'm not proud of it. And girls used underwear vending machines, they're there for business and food source. Some people need it for their survival. And I'm not proud of it. Japan is a small island, and when I lived there with a bunch of Japanese people, I really didn't realize racism existed in the world. But then when I go outside Japan, I experience racism firsthand. Like when my friends want me to be in their photos, they go, "Hey, Yumi, do the girl from The Ring. Put your hair in front of your face." And I do it. He goes, "I am an entertainer." And I'll be like, "There you go." And when I get on a bus, people tend to sit next to me because they just assume Japanese people are small and have good hygiene. So I decided to wear a gigantic mask to make people think I have SARS. This is why Asian people wear masks. They're not sick. They're sick of you. And sometimes I notice white people confuse me with other Asian women. And my friends say, "That's racist." But I don't think so, because face recognition skill is nothing to do with racism, it's racial familiarity. I have trouble distinguishing white people too. This is why I still can't tell the difference between Zooey Deschanel and Katy Perry. Julia Roberts and Steven Tyler. And Matthew McConaughey and brown leather recliner.
All right, all right, all right.
Do you think it's mean to Matthew McConaughey? He wouldn't care. His net worth is $95 million. Yeah. He wouldn't be able to tell the difference between me and rice cracker. Yeah, but I do acting in Vancouver and I go to lots of auditions. And I can't help but notice these unrealistic expectations Hollywood has towards Japanese female characters. While my white girlfriends auditions for the roles like nurse, waitress, or yoga instructors, my roles are like sexy nuclear scientist with IQ 300. Hot assassin schoolgirl with nunchuck and daddy issues. Despite our super advanced technology, Japan is stuck in old ways sometimes. For instance, did you know Hello Kitty didn't have a mouth? Because apparently in Japan, women are so beautiful when they don't talk. Yeah. We are trained to cover our mouth when we laugh in order to hide the secret that we have voice, we have sense of humor, and we have really fucked up teeth. But all joking aside, I moved to Canada from Japan because Canada had better society for women. You, strong, quality Canadian women, give me courage to dispute my phone bill like there's no tomorrow. You go, girl. You go, girl. You guys been so much fun, but I'm gonna leave you on this. I use baby oil to remove my eye makeup. And the very first night I stayed at my boyfriend's place, I took out a big bottle of baby oil from my backpack, and my boyfriend's eyes lit up like a little kid in a candy store. Like, you're into that kind of stuff. And I was like, I don't know what you're thinking, but I use baby oil to remove my eye makeup. On the other hand, I think we will have lots of fun with this. And I took out a gigantic strap-on penis. You know, just to be fair. Okay, that's my time today. Thank you so much.